Today, you'll learn how to edit a time-lapse photo sequence in Lightroom and then how to export your edited files. So, let's get started. Open Lightroom and make sure you are in the Library tab. Click on Import and browse to the folder with your time-lapse photo sequence. Make sure all photos is selected. I will choose Minimal Previews to import the photos as fast as possible into my catalog. I will leave all these options unchecked because they will increase my import time. Next, you can click on Import and wait until all your time-lapse frames or photos will be imported into your folder, which in my case is called Time-lapse. These frames are JPEG and they were taken on my GoPro 4 using the photo time-lapse mode. ProTune was activated, so I got these flat-looking images in terms of contrast and saturation, but it's a good thing because I can tweak the photos easily in Lightroom. As you already know, the GoPro camera has two different time-lapse modes. First is the video time-lapse mode, which in the end creates the final movie for you, and there is also a photo time-lapse mode, which gives you the opportunity to edit your frames separately, and I think this is the best option to do it. And by the way guys, question of the day, leave a comment below and tell me what are you using to shoot your time-lapse. Are you using a smartphone, a DSLR, a GoPro, or who knows, another gadget? You choose, I look forward for your comments. Okay, so you have all the images here. Select the first image and click on the Develop tab. I'm gonna edit the first photo only, and then I will show you a trick to apply the same settings for the rest of the images. The next thing is to check my white balance using this eyedropper. The clouds are supposed to be white or gray, so I will choose the white balance point from here. If you want, you can tweak it more after this, so I will enter a -2 here. And you know what? I will hide the left side here with the F7 on the keyboard because I want to have a bigger working space. I will also activate the before and after option from here so I can have a clearer view from where I've started this editing. I'm going to work on the right side now and set values. I already edited this image before recording this video, so I will just enter the perfect values for me while you can keep an eye on the before and after to see the differences. For the exposure, I'm going to enter 0.7. Contrast, 50. Highlights, -76. I'm going to bring up the shadows to 16. Whites to 6. Blacks, -15. Let's bring up also the clarity to 7 and the vibrance to 30. You see, there is already a big difference from the original, and if you enjoy what I'm doing here, feel free to give me a thumbs up during this tutorial. I will move now to the Saturation tab, and for the orange, I enter 67, for the yellow, 68, and for the green, 6. Let's move on to the Luminance tab, where for the yellow, I enter 45, and for the green, 23. I will sharpen the photo just a bit, let's choose 15 for the sharpening, and I will enable Remove Chromatic Aberration. Now I'm going to go to the Camera Calibration tab. For the red primary, I will change the hue to 25 and the saturation to -10. Also, for the blue primary, I enter -7 for the hue and 66 for saturation. Well, a lot of settings, guys, I know, but take a look how big is the difference from the original flat-looking GoPro image. I will show you how fast you can synchronize the settings of this photo with the rest of the frames that I have in my sequence. But first, let me darken the sky and the clouds to achieve that beautiful blue color, which will look amazing in the time-lapse. I'm going to add a gradient filter and drag it down until I reach the bottom of the trees. I set the temperature to -9 and the exposure to a -0.3. Okay, now it's time to crop the image because if I want to create an HD or a 4K resolution time-lapse, I will need a 16:9 ratio. I will click on the crop tool and choose an aspect ratio of 16:9. I reposition my photo inside my crop, something like this. I want to see more from the sky, and when I'm done, I just press enter. So this is my 16:9 crop, and I'm going back to the before and after. Sometimes it's hard to believe that the original image can be edited to this level. I mean, it looks awesome. And now I will show you how to copy all the settings from this image and apply them to the rest of the photos from this sequence. And when I'm done with this, I will show you how to export this whole sequence and prepare it to be edited in Premiere Pro to obtain that final time-lapse movie. In fact, I already made a tutorial on this and you will find it at the end of this video. Let me show you how to synchronize the settings first. Make sure you select the first image, hit Ctrl plus A to select all the images, and you have this sync button right here. Click on Check All and then click on Synchronize. Now, as you can see, Lightroom is applying the settings to the whole sequence here. If you scroll to the right, you can see that the files are getting updated. Okay, it's time to export the frames now. With all the images selected in the film strip, I go to File, Export. I will choose the folder later. Under the file settings, I make sure JPEG is selected, quality is set to 98, and for the color space, sRGB is selected. The resolution is 300 pixels per inch, and that's it. I don't want to sharpen anything. So now I will click on Export. Lightroom will ask where is the folder where I want to export the files, and I'm choosing this Lightroom Export folder, which is important to be empty. I press Export and Lightroom is preparing to export all my files, and I can see here the progress of this task. It will take some time because I have 670 photos.